I felt a little bit guilty, Rachel, because a few weeks ago, I turned down an invitation from Philippine International Church that should run a series starting last evening until Sunday on this same weekend. And I found myself still here, still in AUP. Anyway, probably the Lord would win over that and allow me to serve for this whole Sabbath day. So we'll run this starting this morning. I'd like you to pick up your papers and pen. If for some reason something in the presentation brings a thought or a question to your heart, you may want to write them down and reserve that till this afternoon. I'm going to make two presentations and I just hope that it will give justice to the chosen topic. Any question you would have, write that down in a piece of paper, hand it over to Rachel, and I'm going to have the time to answer that after lunch. Would that be okay? If you don't come back with your questions, then I would ask if the one who's asking this question is still here. And if not, we might save the time. I still have to get to Lung Center tonight to do another ministry. So I'd like to make the most of our time. Would that be fine? Question and answer till this afternoon. Are you okay with that one? Malungkot kayo. Anyway, let's bow our heads. Let's start with a prayer. Father God, you are the author of love and the wellspring of life. You place in our hearts the desire to even know you better. So we ask, dear Lord, that come with your Holy Spirit and reside in our hearts this morning. Help us to understand the dynamics, the truth, and the joy of knowing you as love itself. Thank you for the sacred truth where we could base our understanding of you as love. We ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen. Those of you who caught this topic over Facebook, you must have seen big the symbol the College of Dentistry came up with. They say sketch of a tooth with a heart in the middle. Did you notice that? Now let's start by noting how many of you are coming from the College of Dentistry? Can I see your hands? Oh, dami yun dyan sa likod. Ba't kayo nandyan? You should be here. Huh? College of Medicine. Can I see your hands? Oh, tatlo lang. College of Nursing. Can I see your hands? Ah, mas marami kayo. Okay. Let's see what we can do with this one. If you notice this, it happens to be a caricature or a sketch of the bulk of the tooth. Whether it's the canine or the molar, you find the bulk inside the tooth. It is the life, it is the exchange inside the tooth. I also wonder why they call it the heart of the pulp, when the pulp is the heart of the tooth. Dentists to be, the pulp is the heart of the tooth. It is the core. Without the pulp, the tooth will lose its life, eventually reducing it to a calcified a dead tooth, and yet it remains for the purpose of aesthetic, for beauty. Mahirap din kasi yung bungal. Di ba? Sino sa inyo ang gusto mag-asawa ng bungal lahat sa harapan? Walang pustito. Probably for your age, you wouldn't, right? And probably think, but siya bungal? We have all sorts of questions. So, the palp is the heart of the tooth. But whether bungal or not, there is something with the palp that tells us of the condition of the heart. The teeth and the heart are very much related. When a dentist would go through and examine from enamel to the renderings of the radiograph of your tooth, they would be able to deduct if you have heart problems. In other words, if out of the radiograph of your tooth they find an occurrence or instance of a stone, they would relate that to a heart dysfunction. It may be the arteries, the veins that leads to the heart, the arteries that leads out from the heart. The presence of the stone in the palp means a dysfunction in the heart. It wasn't so many years ago. They never related the presence of stones in the palp of the tooth to a heart dysfunction. But it was only lately that they were able to conduct a study where they can deduce that out of this, evidence can give that there is significance and relationship between the presence of the stone in the palm and a heart dysfunction. How did they do that? Well, they managed to get 61 patients, did an angiography, gave analyzed the results, and it turned out that 82% of the patients dentists must be good lovers. You should, because if not, you must have a problem. Because when you do an X-ray and find a stone in the mouth, that should notify you and make you understand that there must also be what? A heart disorder. Parang mayroong beses tayo magpapalit ng mind. For a long time, I've been speaking. I'm really unsettled and not very comfortable holding my mind. Hindi maka-express ko at makapagat kung hinahamay ko sa muna. But anyway, getting back to that, there is a relationship between the teeth and the heart. That's the book of life. If you take care of your teeth, I'm sorry, if you take care of your heart, your health, your body, it would also take good care of the heart of your teeth, the heart. In the same analogy, if we take care of our hearts, we will also have a meaningful relationship. All of this are not at all foreign in the scriptures. If you open your Bibles, a similar analogy will be found in Jeremiah chapter 17. Let's look at that one. I hope you know how to open your Bibles. Jeremiah 17, verses 9 to 10. Are you there? Jeremiah 17, verses 9 to 10. Would you mind? I hope you brought your Bibles with you, even the electronic or the digital ones, and mark them, highlight them, or write them down so you won't forget. Jeremiah 17, 9 to 10 tells us, the heart is what? Is deceitful above all things. And the next line depends on what version you're using. I'm using an NIV and it says, the heart is deceitful above all things and beyond. Incurable, I would say. Are you opening your Bibles? You don't want me to be talking and not checking your Bibles. You want to understand this clearly straight from the Bible, not from someone who would care. So look at your Bibles and check them. Write them down, because it's right there. It says, the heart is what? Deceitful. What does that mean? It couldn't be trusted. It may lie. It may not give you the truth. And it is on the superlative above all things. And the sad part of it is that it is what? Incurable. How is it rendered in your translation? He said, I, the Lord, search the heart and examine the mind to reward each person according to their conduct, according to what their deeds deserve. So you see, friends, if we talk about the issues of the heart, most especially with that of your favorite topic on this season of the month, you would not want to trust your heart alone on love matters. Because none of us, even the parent of the heart, can what? Can understand the heart. Kaya siguro meron tayong mga ganitong pagtitipon. The reason why we have such occasions of worship like this, because we couldn't trust the heart. It is deceitful above all things. In the biblical language, the heart is the center of the human spirit. From it springs the emotions, the thoughts, the motivations, the courage, the action, everything that you do flows from it. So while it could be said that the heart is the seat of emotion, the truth is, it is the one. It is the mind who decides. It is the mind who processes the what? The emotions. All of this transpires in the mind. That's why it is the biggest sex organ. Without it, we would not fully fathom how we were made to express emotions and connect with others in love. Indeed, God has gifted us this brain in order to process all of this and experience a phenomenal emotion that only God would have gifted us. So yung mga nararamdaman ninyo, pagka nakita ninyo si Jacob o kaya si Pekka, and your heart throbs so fast, and something in you you do not fully understand, and you call it romantic love, are all processed in this way. It is the mind that the Bible refers to as the heart. Not the physical part where we exchange the nutrients and the discharges of the blood all over our body. Friends, the Bible is never silent on how to love and be loved. God wanted us to have the joy in a romantic relationship. Kaluluwan ng Panginoon na maranasan natin ang tunay na pag-ibig. In fact, God designed us to be related with each other, whether that of filial, brotherly, or the romantic love towards the opposite gender. God wanted all of us to experience it. He even designed us to remain in a divine relationship of husband and wife. Kaya kaluban ng Panginoon na lahat kayo mga anak ay magsipag-asawa. Unless by divine inspiration you were called to a celibate life. Who does that? God. It is not self-imposed. Pare-pareho yung mga lalaki. So, bigger siya. So, she declared herself to be what? To be single for the lifetime. You see, friends, God designed that all of us would experience that meaningful, unexplained mystery of love in that relationship of husband and wife. Ikaw, kalukuban ka ng Panginoon na makasal, makasama. Ganun din ikaw. Sige o di na, panuparan ng Panginoon na kung It is initiated and gift of God, not self-imposed. Kung dalap na sa mga babae, maraming mga babae yan. Hindi na ako mag-aasawa. Hindi maganda yun. Because God wanted us to experience the mystery and the joy of love in a husband and wife relationship. So let you get into a romantic relationship of boyfriend and girlfriend without the end in mind of what? Of getting married. You find friends. You start in with the joy of experiencing that romantic relationship, knowing that your future, the Lord will lead you, will guide you towards a path, towards that special someone you will enjoy forever. Kaya kung mag-boyfriend ka na, mag-girlfriend ka for the sake of mema. Mema sabi na sweetheart, then you are sure of understanding of God's design of true love and meaningful relationship. So, it should have been and in mind na kung si sweetheart ako, ito rin ang magpapakasama ko. Does that make sense to you? Hindi yung kung si sweetheart ako, para may magbigay sa akin chocolate and flowers of temporary. That is never God's desire. God wanted you to have an experience of oneness eventually in a married life. So in the Adventist understanding of love, there is an end in mind. You start with that end in mind. Na kung sasabihin ko ito, si Damian, I am looking forward in the near future when God has appointed the right time, si Damian ang mapapakasama ko. See? So, ingat ka rin sa sasabihin mo. Di ba? Kung sasabihin mo siya para lang na yung nasabi, sweetheart, you are short of understanding of God's design of that emotional and principled thing called love. Concluding in that meaningful relationship, husband and wife. So, parang puso natin, ito rin yung seat of understanding natin. At least in the sense of the scriptures, we need to see that Jeremiah is talking about that we cannot just rely on our own understanding because it is deceitful. What does deceitful mean? Well, checking the Hebrew word for me, it was taken from an understanding similar to that of the name of Jacob. Diba? The deceiver. It has the mind of supplanting. It has the understanding or meaning of supplanting. Yung ipinato mo, inilagay mo on top of something. Or the base of the hill. Something that is not existent or true is a cover up. That is what deceitful means in this context. So ang sabi, yung daw ating kaisipan, yung daw ating damdamin, is actually what? Mapagtuwali, hindi mo magkakatiwalaan, at sinungaling. So you couldn't trust your heart. So that, does that leave us without hope? Getting into romantic relationships, yung pala, yung naramdaman natin, is not and should and couldn't be the basis of true love. You see, it is very important to understand that when you get into a romantic relationship, it should exude from from the right understanding of the offer of love. And only God can lead you in that relationship. So, kung yan ay lifetime partner, then start earning. You couldn't rely with your heart on matters of the heart if you're only going to start preparing for it at the time you're already in love. Tunay. Saka ka pa magbabasa ng Spirit of Prophecy, saka ka pa magbabasa ng Bible, in love ka na kay Douglas. Bako-bako kayo sa mga pangalan ng Mimi. Kung nakapatid yan eh, Jeto, Damian, Douglas. Marami pa kayo narinig na po ng Mimi. Kaya if you will start discovering God's purpose for your life, or understand how it should be repeating. Marami ang nangyayari kay Marcos sa katawan mo, sa utak mo, mula sa sapok mo hanggang sa kagulugan mo, physiologically. And it's very important that we prepare our children at an early age so that they will never be tempted to do the wrong thing. Does that make sense to you, young people? Or should we stop there? When would you prepare for a lifetime commitment? When? Tell me. Di ba nung nag-aaral kayo ng high school, sabi ng nanay, tatay mo, with big one.
also into that character. See? So as early as it and as young as then, you can already begin the understanding. So that before the world could bring its own version of love, you have grounded them in the scriptures. Medyo huli na nasa. I started with our children when they were baptized. When they accepted Christ as their personal Savior at grade 4, I started telling them, it's a joy to be married and have a family in the near future. Then exemplify that in your love relationship with your spouse. They will grow up to have that idea that it is God's design for them to have their own families. Because if they don't do that, they will learn the other version of it from the world. Does that make sense for you, young people? O, tingnan nyo ngayon kayo. Diba? Sometimes you make the questions, as many questions we will answer this afternoon, are as many people who are confused about this topic. So it's important that love must be understood while our children, our young. Proverbs 4:23 tells you, above all else, guard your heart. For everything you do flows from so even the Bible exhorts us to be very careful with what we put in our hearts or in our minds. Jesus, in her short ministry, in Matthew 13, verse 15, said, they guard within the ears, they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I will. So even Jesus recognized the importance of understanding from the heart, from the mind, using your principle over your emotions. So, you put emotion in a spot. Never know. We do not see it that way. Remember, the same God who gave you the capacity to think, the capability to understand, is the same God who gifted you with different emotions to experience. What we only would like to guard apart from is that principle will guide and lead our emotions. We will not allow our emotions to overwhelm principles in life. For by this, we are receiving blessings rather than what? The curse. Young people, now it is beginning in your life that emotion will take a front seat over the principles in life. Everywhere you look at around you, principles are being sacrificed for the name of love for emotions. Be careful, young people, because to this the Bible tells us, guard your heart above all else. It is deceitful. You cannot trust it, especially in the choice of a lifetime partner. I'm glad you chose to study in a dormitory school where you get to see your friends every day. You know, papasalamat doon. Nakikita niyo kung paano sila magdamit the whole week. Pagdating ng week, makikita niyo pa. Araw-araw, kahit sa makikita niya, sa buko, sa nakikita niyo ang laki ng buka ng bibig. Everything, even the body, can be observed as you study together. This is a good place to find friends that eventually in the near future can become your lifetime partners. Does that make sense to you? Kasi yun, kahit na kung na nasa kong sabihin, sa hindi. This is the best time you can put yourself under God's spiritual direction. Choose the right friends. Do not worry to give covenants and commitments. This time is best to gain most of your friends. So then, what about the belief? Magkaroon ka ng napakaraming mga kaibigan, pati na mga lalaki. Magkaroon ka ng maraming kaibigan, pati na mga babae. Kung sino mga babae niyo, magkaroon kaibigan niyo, you will also know from them kung sino yung kanilang mga kaibigan, lalaki. Have as many gentlemen friends as you could have, because from them, as you observe on a daily basis, can be your future.
Some kind of collapse.
in a research from Rutgers University, they found and inspected, observed the abilities in the brain at the moment of love or romanticism. And this is what they found out. They found out that in that area of your brain, you produce neurotransmitters. At least four important neurotransmitters are exchanging. Dopamine, your happy hormones.
Does that make sense to you, young people?
What Satan does is circumventing and short-sighted it. He will introduce the sexual intimacy well at the drive. Can you imagine what happens if he places the sexual intimacy at the drive stage? As many people as you see whom you like to be acquainted with, you will be what? Also sexually acquainted with them. It's either petty, it's either sexual intimacy by the use of games, or even sexual intimacy itself. Sexual intimacy must happen when it ends or when at the attachment phase. Kaya, pag nilangon niyo yung tatlo niyo, disgrasya niyo. Can you imagine if you put sex at the time of focus, you will lose your opportunity to sustain it. Bakit? Oh, man. Because it will be very important to focus when you are already sexually related to the person. You see, oxytocin and vasopressin are those that are being produced at the time of what God's having sex. And it bonds you permanently to that person. Imagine if as many sexual activities you make to as many people, you release oxytocin and vasopressin to make this permanent. And it will confuse the heart, it will confuse the mind, so that it will also make your principles vain. Young people, the Lord designed us to be faithful in love. Fidelity is His character. We want to follow the dynamics for which God has created us. So be very careful, young people. Even the touch itself can reject, can exude intimacy. Kaya pahabos ka ng pahabos ng buhok mo. That is sending impulses. Hawak-hawak kayo ng kamay. Diyan pa kuya masakit dyan eh. Kuya-kuya. So be very careful, because our body is designed to be attached and permanent to someone, the Lord has given you. So be very careful with that one. You may feel in love after that, because all of those hormones. So reserve sex for the best. Be very careful not to do it in the earlier stages. Dahil pag yun ang nangyari, wala. Tapos. Proverbs 3 verses 5 to 7 gives the counsel. Trust in the Lord in all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will what? Direct or make your paths straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord, and shall be there. Shall be there. Appearance of evil pala, lumayo na. You follow, young people? The appearance of evil itself, lumayo ka na. Because it can engage you. You see, the more our society is confused now,